to play chess. Before simultaneous exhibition, I learned several words about chess world, what is going on now, because chess is just a part of culture, and what is going on in chess is interesting itself. You know, chess world is a like monarchy. Usually a world champion who is like a king with the rules in the chess. And for a long time, for decades, we had a very strong and serious king, Garry Kasparov. He dominated chess starting with 85, 86, over 20 years. After Garry left chess, chess world became like, it's not a democracy, but it like, you know, history like Polish kingdom, when people had a king, but nobody considered him seriously. Now world champion, you know, is a very nice guy, very nice chess player, Anand Vishwanathan. It's strange that in all chess magazines his first name used as his last name, because Vishwanathan is very long, so he goes as Anand, despite his first name. He's near 40 years old, and he was on the top of chess hierarchy for 20 years ago. He played a match with Garry Kasparov, of course, it was in New York in World Trade Center, on the topest of floor. But after Garry resigned chess, it was somewhere 5 years ago, Anand was lawful replacement of Garry. But in today's world, it's difficult to say that he is the strongest. He has a title, but we have several very interesting persons as well. One of them is Vladimir Kramnik. Kramnik, 10 years ago, almost 10 years ago, won match with Garry and became world champion. Recently he lost a match to Anand, but it's difficult to say who is the stronger, Anand or Kramnik. Yesterday I finished a very strong tournament in Moscow, the memorial of Mikhail Tat, great world champion. And Kramnik won very decisively, and Anand played not badly, but he lost terribly yesterday, last game, and he wasn't even among first three. It shows that in the age of 40, he already has not so strong nerve system. It's very important quality for a professional chess player to survive very stressful situations. So he's a world champion, but now I would say that he's one of several. So I mentioned Vladimir Kramnik, who beat Kasparov, so he is really great. Our great is Veselin Topalov, it's Grandmaster from Bulgaria. He also had title world champion, but not very serious world champion. After Kasparov, all ours considered not so serious. But now we have a couple of young players who can really take a shoes of Kasparov. Brightest one is Magnus Carlsen. He is 18 years old, a guy from Norway. It's interesting that now he has a very good trainer. His trainer today is Garry Kasparov. So we work Garry, who decided not to play chess when he became 41 years old. He resigned from chess, but as I understand, he has a very strong feeling with chess, and he tries to have world champion by proxy. So he tries to help to Carlsen to beat our players. And I think he will be successful because Carlsen is so bright star, he can beat our players even without help, especially with help. It is a very interesting combination. Carlsen is a chess player with very clear logical style. A chess player in the style of great world champions. History like Capablanca, Maslov. Garry Kasparov is a very aggressive, dynamic player. So if he really will teach Carlsen what Carlsen doesn't know well, can be created really universal great chess player. So among young players, brightest star is Magnus Carlsen, and one more guy, it's Levon Aranyan. It's a guy from Armenia. He lives in Germany for many years, but he plays as an Armenian chess player. Also very interesting player. Yesterday he won this last game against Anand, I believe. He beat world champion already several times. And he is very different with our great players. Greatest chess players work very much with openings. They remember long theoretical lines and develop theory of chess. And because of deep knowledge, we very often crush our opponents, even in the time of preparation. So great chess player can come to the game, demonstrate what he, his research, what he made at home, and then. Aranyan is a rare player who is lazy. He doesn't work much at home, but because he has very bright and original talent, he outplays chess players in unclear positions. So, if to take all players I mentioned and organize tournament, the winner of this tournament will be strongest player. But only problem, if you will organize such tournament months later, it will be different. So now it's really chess is not completely monarchy, but not completely democracy. We have several very bright and strong players, and because of this, each tournament on high level is a big mystery and big intrigue and very interesting for chess players who follow chess. And maybe a couple of questions if you have about chess. After this, we'll start with you. So, do you have questions? Yeah?
You say, you're saying you're putting the younger players versus, you say, our players.
Yes.
So do you think that there is a very big generational gap in terms of, do you think that we're on a point where the younger players are going to take over chess?
Yes. Now, really, I mentioned two young players, Carlsen and Aranyan, who is around 20. Carlsen before 20, Aranyan after 20, and players who are around 40. And strangely enough, almost nobody beat it. Because chess is a very stressful sport, today players to 40 years, they already have not so strong nerve system, they little spoiled. So take your results quietly, but not be too upset if the game is not so successful. So because of this, Kasparov, I think greatest player in the history, in the very young age, 40 or 41, I don't remember now exactly, resigned from chess. As I understand, he feel that his results will go down, and of course, for player who was so great chess legend, it will be not very pleasant. So, Grandmasters around 40, I think we already finished above the best results, and I think next world champions have to be best players around 20. And now, because the help of computers, and now it's much easier to make research and to have information, players in the younger age reach highest results. So players to 20 already ready to fight for world championships. So I think the next world champion, will be determined in the match Anand Topalov, which will be next spring in Bulgaria. So only one of these two will be world champion. But next champion, I think it will be or Carlsen or Aranyan, guys who are around 20. So really, future of chess belong to these young guys.